I can't see it.
Children, so let us see the fourth property of multiplication. Up to now we have discussed three properties. Now the fourth property. So what is the fourth property? If you multiply three numbers and if you group any two numbers in any order, if you group them in any order, the product will be same. So multiply three numbers. So children, if you multiply three numbers and if you group them in any order, if you group any two numbers among the three numbers in any order, so if you group them in any order, if you group them in any order, the product is same. The product is same. Children, this is the fourth property. That means if you take three numbers and if you want to multiply these three numbers and if you group any two numbers among the three numbers and if you group them in any order, the product will be same. So children, let us see an example to understand this property. So see an example. So here I will take three numbers. In this property, we have to multiply three numbers. Here I will take three numbers, that is 3, 4, 5. I will take three numbers, 3, 4, 5. And I want to multiply these three numbers. That's why I put the symbol into and group them in any order. Now group any two numbers among these three numbers. So group any two numbers among these three numbers. Now I will group these two numbers and let us find the product is how much. And again I will again multiply these three numbers, 3 into 4 into 5, but now I will group these two numbers. So in the first case I have grouped the last two numbers, and in the second case I have grouped the first two numbers. So I will find the product. And now in the third case, I will group among these three numbers, I will group these lines. So I will group the 3 and 5 and again find how much answer we will get. So children, do you understand the grouping? How to group in the two numbers? So these are the three numbers, 3, 4 and 5. In the first case, I have grouped the two numbers 4 and 5. In the second case, I have grouped the two numbers 3 and 4. And in the third case, I have grouped the numbers 3 and 5. So in this way, if you multiply three numbers and group any two numbers among these three numbers, the product will be same in each case. The answer will be same in each case. Let us find out the answers for these three products. So let us see the answer for the first product. So let us see. So in any problem, you have to multiply the numbers which are kept in bracket. So these are called brackets. These are called brackets. Brackets also means multiplication. So let us do. So first, I will kept 3 as the same. And now do the product. So do the multiplication 4 into 5. Children, how much 4, 5 jar? 20. And 23 jar, children, how much? 23 jar, how much? So do this multiplication, your rough work. Already you have learned how to multiply a number with a single number. Now how you multiply here? 20 and 3. Children, multiply first. So multiply 3 with the 1's place first. Where, what is the 1's place? 0. 3, 0, 0. 3 into 0, children, 0. And next multiply 3 with the 10's place. 3, 2, 6. So the product is 6. The answer is 60. The answer is 60. Now see the answer for the second case. So children, so let us do the multiplication of the grouped numbers. So we have to multiply the numbers which are grouped first. So now here 3 and 4 are grouped. So multiply 3 and 4. 3 4s are how much? 12. 3 4s are 12. And into write the third number as it is. Now children, 12 5s are. This is the 12th table. 12 5s are how much? Again 16. See the third case. So first multiply the numbers which are grouped. So which numbers are grouped here? 3 and 5. So multiply first those two numbers. 3 5 are how much? 3 5 are 15. And write the third number 4 as it is. Now 15 4 are. This is the 15th table. Children, 15 4 are how much? Again 15 4 are 60. So in the three cases, the product is same. The product is same. Children, this is the fourth property. So if you multiply any three numbers and group them in any order, if you group any two numbers in any order, you will get the same product. So this is the fourth property, and this property can also be called as associative property, and you will learn this property in higher classes. So this property is also called as associative. So associative property, and you can learn this in higher classes. So this property is called as associative property. So children, remember these four properties. So these properties, by using these four properties, we can practice the problems in exercise.
Hi children, good morning. Up to now we have discussed different properties of multiplication. That is, we have discussed four properties of multiplication. That is, multiplication of a number with 0 and multiplication of a number with 1 and multiplication of two numbers in any order. And fourth one is multiplication of three numbers, and if we group any of two numbers, we get the same number. So these are the four properties of multiplication. So now we will practice some problems using these properties of multiplication. So let us go to exercise 4.1. So exercise 4.1. So use the properties of multiplication to fill in the blanks. Children, so see the board. There are some blanks are given. We have to fill these blanks by using properties of multiplication. So let us see the first problem, that is the first blank. 10 into 1. Here 10 is the number and the 10 is multiplied by 1. According to properties of multiplication, if any number is multiplied with 1, then we will get the same answer. That is, we will get the same number. So 10 into 1, again we will get 10. So because if a number is multiplied by 1, we will get the same number. Next is the second blank, children. 105, that is 105 into 0. 105 into 0. Here the number is 105 and that number is multiplied by 0. So according to properties of multiplication, if any number is multiplied with 0, we will get 0 as the product. So if any number is multiplied with 0, we will get 0 as the product. That means the product of a number and 0 gives 0. So the answer is 0. So write 0 in the blank. Now see the third blank. So children, so you are observing three numbers here. That is 5 into 6 into 7. So here three numbers are multiplied and two numbers are grouped. So among these three numbers, 5 and 6 are grouped. So this bracket represents grouping of numbers. Here the two numbers are grouped. So here see the children, 5 into dash into 6. 5 into dash into 6. So according to properties of multiplication, so if we multiply three numbers and if we group any two of them, if we group any two of them, we will get the same number. So among three numbers, here the numbers 5 and 6 are grouped, but here which numbers have to be grouped? Here 5 and 6 are given. Which number is missed among three numbers? So among 5, 6 and 7, the number 7 is missed here. So write 7 here. So children, first observe which number is missed among these three numbers. The given three numbers are 5, 6 and 7, but in the blank, so 5 and 6 are given, but the number 7 is missed here. So write 7 in this blank. That means the numbers of 5 and 7 are grouped here. So the answer is the same for both. If we group any two of the numbers, we will get the same product. Now go to the next blank. Children, see the blank. 43 into 19 into 28 is equal to 19 into dash into 28. So which number has to be written in the blank? Children, here also three numbers are given and these three numbers are multiplied. So if three numbers are multiplied, so see here, which number is missed here? Among three numbers, 43, 19, 28, these are the three numbers, but here only two numbers are given and the third number is missed here. So which number is missed? 19 and 28 are given, but 43 is missed here. So write 43 in the blank. So write 43 in the blank. So according to properties, so if we multiply in any order, the order of multiplication of numbers is does not matter, and we will get the same answer if we multiply the numbers in any order. So here 43 is taken in the first place, 19 is taken in the second place. But here 19 is taken in the first place, 43 is taken in the second place. The order of the numbers is changed here. So whatever the order of the numbers, we will get the same product. So among these three numbers, the number 43 is missed here. So write 43 in the blank. So now go to the next problem. 222 into 100 is equal to 100 into dash. Children, which number has to be written in this blank? Here two numbers are multiplied. First number is 222 and second number is 100. But whereas in this product, only the first number 100 is given and another number is missed here. So which number has to be written here? So which number is missed? So 100 is given, but 222 is not given. So 222 is missed here. So write 222 in the blank. So that means the order of product is, the order of multiplication of numbers is not the matter. If you multiply the two numbers in any order, we will get the same product. So here 222 is taken in the first place and 100 is taken in the second place. Whereas 100 is taken as the first place and 222 is taken in the second place. So here the order is changed. Whatever is the order of the numbers, the multiplication, if we do, we will get the same product. So children, so see the sixth blank. 23 into 1 is equal to dash. Here the number is 23. The 23 is multiplied with 1. According to properties of multiplication, if any number is multiplied with 1, we will get the same number. So 23 into 1, again we get 23. Children, see the next blank. 6507 into 0 is equal to dash. 6507 into 0 is equal to dash. So here the number is 6507, the number is multiplied with 0. According to properties of multiplication, if we multiply any number with 0, again we will get 0. If we multiply any number with 0, again we get 0. So the answer is 0, write 0 in the blank. So children, see the eighth blank. So here three numbers are given, that is 4 × 7 × 8, and the two numbers 7 and 8 are grouped here. Here the bracket represents grouping. The two numbers 7 and 8 are grouped here. Now see here, 7 × –8. So 7 × –8. Among these three numbers, one number is missed here. So which number is missed here? So among 4, 7, 8, 7, 8 are given, but 4 is not given here. That means the number 4 is missed here. So write 4 in the blank. So that means here 7 and 8 are grouped here, but whereas 4 and 8 are grouped here. So here 7 and 8 are grouped here, whereas here 4 and 8 are grouped. So according to the properties of multiplication, if any two numbers are grouped among three numbers, we will get the same product. Now see the ninth blank. 238 × 42 = 42 × –. So here also same. Here the first number is 238 and the second number is 42. Whereas here 42 is taken as the first number and the number is missed here. Which number is missed here? So which number has to be written? Among these two numbers, that is among 238 and 42, 42 is given, but 238 is missed here. So write 238 in the blank. That means the order of the numbers is changed here. So here the order of multiplication is changed. That is 238 is taken in the first place, 42 is taken in the second place. So whereas here 42 is taken in the first place, 238 is taken as the second place. So their places are changed. That means the order of the multiplication is changed here according to multiplication. So whatever is the order, so if you multiply any two numbers in any order, we will get the same product. Next, see the 10th problem here. So here three numbers are given, 354 × 312 × 0 = –. So how much answer we will get, children, here? So if you multiply any number with 0, what will we get? If you multiply any number with 0, again we will get 0. Here, if you multiply 312 with 0, we will get 0 as the answer. And if you multiply again this 354 with 0, again we will get 0. So the answer is 0. So children, remember, if there is 0 in the multiplication, the total product becomes 0. So remember, if 0 is present in the multiplication, then the product is 0. So that's why write 0 in the blank. So this is exercise 4.1. So children, up to now we have practiced some problems in exercise 4.1 by using properties of multiplication. Now let us go to the next topic in this chapter, that is multiplying a 3-digit number by a 1-digit number. So children, you have learnt in the second class, that is the multiplication of 2-digit number by a single digit number in the second class. So whereas in this class, that is in third class, you are going to learn how to multiply a 3-digit number by a single digit number, that is 1-digit number. So in this multiplication, there are two types, and the first type is multiplying The first type is multiplying without regrouping, and the second type is multiplying with grouping. So first we will going to learn, so how to multiply a 3-digit number by a 1-digit number without regrouping, So let us see an example. So multiply 342 by 2. So children, here 342 is a 3-digit number. So how many digits are there? So 1, 2, 3. So this is a 3-digit number. And here 2 is a 1-digit number, that is the single digit number. So now we have to multiply this 342 with 2. So first we have to write these two numbers one below the other. So write these two numbers one below the other. So first write 342. So children, first write 342. And write 2 below it. So where we have to write 2? So 2 write in the first place, that is in 1's place. So here, what is the symbol here? So the symbol is called into, and it represents multiplication. Now we are going to do multiplication. So that's why write the symbol into. Put the symbol into. So the first step is we have to write the two numbers one below the other. So write the number in the first and write 2 below it. And write the places first. So this is 1's place, and this is 10's place, and 3 is present in 100's place. So in 342, 2 is in 1's place, 4 is in 10's place, 3 is in 100's place. So write the places first. Now the 2 should be written under 1's place. So the number with which we have to multiply should be written under 1's place. So children, now, so the multiplication is the same as the multiplication of a number with a 2-digit number as in the second class. Already you have learnt how to multiply a 2-digit number with a single-digit number. So here also the process is the same. We have to continue in the same process as you have done in the second class. So first here, so we have to multiply this. So we have to multiply, so this 2 with 2 first. So let us start multiplication from 1's place. So multiply with 1's place. Multiply with the digit present in the 1's place. The first step is, so first multiply with the digit present in the 1's place. Which digit is present in the 1's place? 2 is present in the 1's place. So multiply 2 with 2. That is 2 into 2. So children, how much we will get? We will get 4. So write 4 here. So after completing 1's place, now go to 10's place. So children, so we have multiplied the number with the digit present in the 1's place. So I have multiplied 2 with 2. Now multiply with the digit present in the 10's place. So now go to 10's place. So multiply with the digit present in the 10's place. Which digit is present in the 10's place? 4 is present in the 10's place. So multiply 4 with 2. That is 2 into 4. So 2 into 4. Children, how much we will get? 2 4s are 8. So write 8 here under 10's place. So multiply with the digit present in the 1's place and write the answer under 1's place. And multiply the digit present in the 10's place and write the answer in the 10's place. So here multiply 4 with 2, 2 4s are 8. And now go to 100's place. So here 1's place is completed. So multiplication with the 10's place is completed. Now go to 100's place. So now multiply the digit present in the 100's place with 2. So that is 2 into 3, that is equal to 2, 3 jar, 6. The answer is 6. So write this answer under 100's place. So children, so this is the process. So how to multiply a 3-digit number with a single-digit number? So first write the two numbers one below the other and start multiplication from 1's place. So first multiply the digit present in the 1's place with 2. So which digit is present in the 1's place? 2 is present in the 1's place. So multiply this 2 with 2. That is 2 into 2 is equal to 4. 2 2s are 4. Now go to tens place. Multiply the digit present in the tens place with 2. That is 2 fours are 8. So write this 8 under tens place. Now go to hundreds place. So multiply the digit present in the hundreds place with 2. That is 2 threes are, so 2 threes are 6. Write this 6 under hundreds place. So the answer is 684. So children, so this is the way. So how to multiply a 3-digit number with a single-digit number without regrouping. So now let us practice some problems on this multiplication without regrouping in exercise part. So let us go to exercise 4.2.